Hello and welcome to C++ Weekly. I am your host, Jason Turner. I am available for code reviews and on-site training. You should check out the links in this week's episode to learn more about upcoming workshops that I'm going to be teaching at conferences near you. Look for me to do workshops at C++ on C, CVPCon, NDC Tech Town, pretty much every year. And then also a few other conferences such as ACCU, perhaps in other years. In this episode, I'm going to talk about map extract. Set also has extract. So does multi-map, multi-set, unordered map, unordered multi-map, unordered set, and unordered multi-set. But we'll just use map as our example here. This was a feature that was added in C++ 17 that you might not be familiar with or have any idea why you would want to use it. We're going to use just the most straightforward example of using a map. We're going to do like a key value kind of thing. Things get rather annoying to think about here. If I use the index operator to insert a string integer pair, this is actually going to be a new string created here with the hello world long string, which will then be moved into a node in the map, which will then come back as a reference to the value part of the node, which we're then assigning to one. So a surprising amount of work is happening here. It's one new string created, it's a move, and then this assignment operator. We're going to go ahead and set up a few things. Now I'm going to use short strings here because why not? We can reason more about the number of allocations that are happening. And if we were to use PMR and have some way of actually tracking these things, then we would actually be able to observe that there were three allocations happening here. But this is required to be an allocation. Every single one of these things is required to be an allocation because these things must be separately allocated. The standard requires this. So if I wanted to create a second map and I wanted to, say, move some of these values between them, I might be able to do something like new map dot insert a original dot begin or something like that. And I'm going to get an efficient, well, no, that's not even compiling. Oh, that's great. There are 10 candidates. Okay, because there's no overload that takes just a single iterator to say insert this value. It has to be a range, or it has to be a node, or it has to be a position followed by a new node or an initializer list. And you can see the 10 overloads here. Eventually, we're going to look at this one in a moment here. Now, I have presumably made a copy of each of these nodes. That's going to be three more allocations. It was probably a relatively efficient thing to do, but we can go ahead and print these things and verify what is happening. Okay, not surprisingly, we see that they both contain all three values. Now, I have updated this so that I am only taking a copy of the first element by using original.begin to original next of original.begin. All right, this is not surprising stuff. The point of this is, what is the point of extract and insert? So we have extract and merge and insert. So merge attempts to extract each element in the source and insert it into the new element efficiently, so it's going to steal these things. Let's go ahead and try to do this merge and stealing of these items. Now, this is like kind of an obvious thing that many of us have needed to do over the years. You've got a couple of maps and they have a different set of values in them, maybe some sort of overlap. So I'm expecting original 2 to be empty, or at least mostly empty. Original to remain intact. Yeah, original 2 is empty. and merged to contain all five of the values. So we stole those values out of original two when we did the merge. The point here is that the standard library is able to just steal those nodes. So let's go ahead and try to steal another node from the first one. Now notice this takes a key or an iterator. So let's go ahead and steal from the original the thing called value one. And now we have this as a node that we've taken from this container, and we can insert into another container if we want to. As we can see here, the original container now no longer contains value one. Now notice that this insert that can take a node type must take it by our value reference. So this one is going to compile because extract is going to return in temporary. That is going to be something that is implicitly convertible to an R value reference. And in this case, this implicit conversion is one that we would keep in the standard. But if I want to steal this one that's currently on the stack, I'm going to have to explicitly cast to an R value reference with standard move. We can see the container of stolen goods is going to contain. Well, as you can see here, I made a mistake and I was populating original instead of original two with all these values, but the basic idea still holds. Let's go ahead and comment out these stolen extracted things so we can go back to reasoning about just original, original two, and merged. Okay, we have original has the values 1, 2, and 3 in it. Original 2 has the value 3 in it only because it is the value that was left over after I merged original 2 into this merged container. So merged has a copy of everything that was in original, then merged steals everything that was in original 2 that was not in original. So this is the leftover value here. And now I have values 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 in merged. Now we're going to go ahead and do this steal a node thing. So we're stealing this from originals. Now original is going to have value 1 stolen from it, and it will have values 2 and 3 left over. Now let's go ahead and create our container of stolen goods. It's going to have that moved from stolen extracted value from the original. And it's going to have the directly extracted node from original. So now stolen goods should contain 1 and 2. There we go. And original 1 contains only the value 3 because it was the one that I didn't steal from it. Original 2 contains only the value 3 because that was the leftover after the merge. The merge has properly merged all of these 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5. Okay. You know, sometimes videos don't go always as I planned for them to go. And sometimes I just roll with it. This is going to be one of these times. Everything that I said was correct originally, but the code sample was wrong. And we have these comments in here. The point of extract, insert, and merge is to reuse nodes that were allocated for one container into another container while avoiding a copy, a move, or another allocation. That is the entire point of these things. Merge is probably useful to a lot of you, and you're probably wondering why we didn't have this before, and that is a great question. Thank you for watching this episode of C++ Weekly. I hope you enjoyed it. Hope you learned about some new features that were added in C++ 17 that I had not yet covered. And be sure to subscribe.